poor creatures of the forest walk and walk and find nothing to sustain them.
Relun!
Finally decided to grace me with your presence, have you?
And with a Sarentu, no less. Exciting, is it not?
Another lost soul for you to guide over the rocky ravines of life. Betterment awaits, Sarentu.
Ah, still cross, I see.
If you are smart, you will not let this one fill your head with silk and dye. The heart of the Aranahe is taste.
Relun is a prickly one, but he is the very best.
Have a look, then. Go on now.
Relun is a prickly one, but he is the very best cook. He knows it too. And here, my dear friend, Kitangi.
Nafika! Taking the Sarentu under your wing already?
A necessity, I should think. Look at these clothes. Pitiful. Rough and prickly like a hermit bud. You lack the grace of your ancestors. They knew how to dress.
Rough and prickly is what I'm used to.
Well, now you will shine brightly. Rival the rainforest with our colors, my own too. Our silk will serve you well. Strengthened with storm beast hide, it will stop you from getting chewed up out there. Or at least, you will be hard to swallow.
Storm beast? Can this child track? I've done okay so far.
Okay? What do we think of okay? Do you thrive on okay, child? Or do you only survive?
Itu is on a hunt. I'm sure he will make a fine guide.
Indeed, if you can find him. There is a hunting camp near the water. Itu will be there. But do not upset his hunt. He will not thank you for that.
Go on, my Auntu. A respectful hunt will show Katnat. You remember the ways of the people. There is no need to...
What is it you need?
Stay sharp, young one.
Katna is inflexible as stone.
Shotlek, I made it to the Aranahe. You weren't wrong about them. But one of them took me in, Nafika. She thinks I can impress Katnat if I show him I can hunt properly.
They sent you on a hunt? I should have showed you how myself.
It's okay. Nafika said one of their hunters might show me how. Itu.
Be careful. You do not need to prove yourself to them. You are Sarentu, and Katnat should honor that. Come back to HQ anytime you like, all right? You are not alone, and there is much to do here.
Fresh herbs bring the dish alive.
Stranger.
Late thou calls these berries ripe.
Have you seen Vu'an? I am worried about her.
Home tree 8. It cannot.
What
hold
clan
so
are you?
Many king lord in the nest.
Flowers again. They will nest in other places.
Not this color.
But
no.
When?
Too dark.
This is too much.
Do you know where Vu'an is? She promised she would bring me dyeing materials, but she has been gone forever.
I don't know who that is. Sorry.
I cannot gather my own supplies. I have no ikran. Vu'an offered to help, but what if something happened to her because of me?
I can look for her if you like.
Oh, could you? She likes the forage near Shaded Grove. Perhaps you could ask around for her there.
You there. Come. Quick. Sky people. Just along the river. They are like any unwelcome guest. They go where they wish, leave a huge mess, and move on. This time, however, it was just one of them. Alone on a small island with a large fallen tree. That is strange, yes? Have we allowed them to become braver?
A lone human? Are they still where you saw them?
Oh, this human learned quickly. They were chased off. They ran away screaming, and I had a hearty chuckle at that. Nevertheless, I worry what enticed a human to that place. No time for chats with strangers. I cannot... face Katna today. He carries such disdain in his gaze.
trouble.
Some kind of a totem. It looks familiar somehow. Ri'nela, I found something. I think it's a totem. Old. The colors and weaving are a bit worn, but it looks Sarentu.
Another of our people's totems. Noah has also seen one.
Another? So there's even more out here.
There has to be. Noah also saw painted symbols near the totem. Is there something like that near yours? He wondered if the symbols meant for him to look in a specific direction, as though showing the way.
And did he see anything? I'd like to try. Maybe I can find the right perspective. Totem. It's looking up at the giant archway. A solid, towering rock formation. And yet, I feel warmth? I wonder how many of our people have traveled under those stone arches. Was it a meeting place for friends, maybe? It's strangely inviting. Even after probably generations, it still stands. It's almost like it's telling me, "Welcome home."